Arkanaut companies form the core of any Kharadron Overlord fleet, mercantile privateers who fight solely for profit. And in this video, we're going to show you how to paint one in the colour scheme of Barak-Nar, the City of the First Sunrise, which is the colour scheme that you can see on the box. Now, I've been looking forward to painting these miniatures for a long time because I think they're fantastic. So let's waste no more time and get to it. For this miniature, I've chosen to use the undercoat Mechanica's standard grey spray because it's an excellent starting point for all the colours that we're going to use. And the colour to start with is, of course, the main one for their overalls, which will be Screamer Pink. Now, as always, be sure to shake all your paints before you use each colour. And I'm going to be applying this using a medium base brush, which is an ideal size for the kind of area we want to cover here. Now, what you need to do is use a palette here, and I'm going to use one throughout this video. It's really useful for helping to control your paint. And in this case, we also need to thin it down with a little bit of water. You don't need much, just a slight dab to it there like that, just to thin it down so it's a bit smoother like this. And by doing this, we'll keep all that detail nice and sharp. So once you've got that mix, all you've got to do is start applying this to the overalls. And you don't need to worry about being neat at this stage, you just need to make sure you catch all these bits of the fabric. So you just want to block them in like this. And if you can see any of the undercoat showing through once you've applied it, just apply a second thin coat in exactly the same way to ensure you've got a strong finish before you move on to the next colour. I finished base coating those overalls now, and you can see I've not really been all that neat with them. I just made sure I've painted all the fabric with Screamer Pink, because now we're going to start neatening up as we add further base colours. The next one we're going to add is Lead Belcher, and this is for all the silver parts of the metal. And I'm going to be applying this using a medium layer brush. It's an excellent size for this kind of detail here. And as before, what you want to do is use your palette to get the paint under control. So thin it down to around about that sort of consistency there. Make sure you don't have too much of it on your brush by just twisting it to get rid of the excess paint. And when you're ready, all you've got to do is start base coating in all the silver parts. And you'll see as I do this now, I start to neaten up on that Screamer Pink just there. So you want to be careful whenever you're getting close to the overalls. But as for the rest of it, don't worry about the details yet, because again, we'll be neatening up as we add further base colours on. As before, you'll want to get a good finish here, so apply two thin coats and take your time, like I say, around the Screamer Pink parts. Now the Lead Belcher has been applied, we have three more base colours yet to add before we start putting some shade on the miniature. The first of these is going to be Balthazar Gold. This is to base coat all the brass and the gold parts at the same time. Then we're going to use some Zandri Dust to base coat all the leather straps, and finally a Baden Black for the boots. But we're going to be starting with Balthazar Gold, and I'm going to be applying this again mostly using a medium layer brush, but at this point it's a good idea to have a small layer brush in hand because you will need it for some of the finer details. And as before, use your palette to thin your paint down so it's flowing really smoothly, and then it's just a matter of picking out whichever parts you want to be both brass or gold. Now we will make a distinction between the two of them later on, but for now you just want to base coat all those parts with the same colour. So I'm going to start on the face here, just picking out some features of it, and it's really up to you which bits you do with this part. But if you want some advice, what I recommend you do is just check out the box art, and that'll give you some great ideas for what components to pick out here. The next colour to apply is Zandri Dust, and this is for all the leather strapping. So we've got all these parts on the body here, but also, if there's this fabric on the miniature, then you need to paint this with this colour at this part as well. One last detail to paint with Zandri Dust is a little roundel on the shoulder plate here, and you'll need to apply two thin coats on all these details. And finally, painting all the soft parts of the boots using a Baden Black. Now that we've finished applying all our base colours, we're ready to add some shade to the miniature. And for this, we just need one shade. We're going to use Norn Oil for this, which, once the model's done, will give a nice clean appearance to it. An alternative, though, is to use Agrax Surshade instead if you want a more weather-worn appearance, but the choice really is yours. Whatever the case, what you need to do is get hold of a medium shade brush to apply this, and what you do is just get some of it onto your palette so you can gauge exactly how much you're applying at once. Now, at first, you want to put on quite a lot, but as you add more and more, you'll just need a bit more control, and the palette will really help with that. But to start out, what you need to do is just start applying this all over your miniature, and you'll see it settles nicely in all that recess detail and helps it jump out. Now, when you're applying this much shade onto a miniature, it'll take around about an hour to dry, but as it dries, just keep an eye on it, because the shade will tend to run towards the bottom of the miniature and pool, in particular just around these parts here on the greaves. So just keep an eye out for that, and if you see it starting to happen, just use your brush to move away the excess shade. The shade's now completely dry, and you can see just how much depth it's given to the miniature. However, it has darkened it down quite a bit, and it's quite a distinctive feature of these miniatures to have bright silver armour. So what I'm going to do is go back to applying Lead Belcher, but this time I'm going to apply it much more precisely to brighten it back up again. I'm going to be using a small airbrush this time to apply it, and what we want to do is, as before, use the palette to thin your paint down so it's flowing really smoothly. Very important in this stage because we need lots of control over it. You're looking for about that sort of consistency, and make sure you don't have loads of it on your brush before you start to apply it. And what we're looking to do here is to paint over all the silver that we've done. However, this time you want to avoid all the recessed areas where the shade's settled the most. So for example, if you look at this arm we've got here, this little ring of metal around there, you can see how the shade's settled in that recess in the corner around those rivets. So what I'm going to do is just avoid that part and paint on the flatter part there like that, just to brighten it up a little bit and still keep that depth in the recessed area. And exactly the same on here. On this flatter part, I'm going to paint a layer of this colour, avoiding the little recess there and carrying on just on the other side of it. The silver's now much brighter, but we've still got that depth from the shade. And with that done, we're ready to move on to the next step, which is to make that difference between the bronze and the gold parts. For this, we need Gehenna's gold, and we're going to apply it using a small layer brush. And what you want to do here is just pick out all the features that you want to be gold. So really looking at the more decorative parts of the metallics. Now, you don't need very much of this, and as always, be sure to thin it down with some water so you've got lots of control over it. And when you're ready, you just need to start picking out these features. And you're looking for the little things like roundels, but also in particular on the face. And when it comes to the face, look for things like the nose, the moustaches, just little details like that. If you want a bit of guidance, then once again just check out the box art, because that will give you some great ideas. Once you're happy with all that gold, you're now ready to start highlighting your miniature. And for this, we're going to start out on the overalls, for which we need Jean Stealer Purple. Now this I'm going to be applying with a small layer brush again, and what you want to do here is to thin it down on your palette a little bit more than normal. So the kind of consistency you want is something like this. See, it's quite transparent, and when you're ready, make sure you get rid of the excess off your brush, because you want some very thin lines for this. And what you want to do is just look on the miniature for any creases in the fabric. And we've got a few on the back here. What you do is just follow along the sharpest points of those creases just to pick them out very lightly. Now the overalls are highlighted, we're ready to start highlighting all the silver parts of the armour. And for this we need Stormhost Silver, again applied to the small layer brush, and the technique we're going to do here is called edge highlighting. What you need to do is again use your palette to get your paint ready, but you want to get a really fine tip on your brush here. So thin it down and then to use that palette to get it under control. And when you're ready, what you're looking to do is to literally paint lines along all the sharpest edges. So sometimes you'll have to keep your hand steady. For example, on areas like the collar just here, what I'm going to do is just follow along that edge there like that to pick out that detail. But other times you can actually use the side of your brush, for example in the sword here, just angle the brush about 45 degrees against the detail and then just run it along there like that, and you get a nice neat straight line really easily. Now one other thing to watch for are any little rivets and things, in which case you just need to pick them out really gently with this colour. I've finished highlighting with all that silver now, and if you look carefully, I've also picked out the very centre of the eyes as well, which we'll come back later on to add some colour to it, because now we have a few more colours left to highlight, and the technique is the same as what we've been doing so far, so we're just going to run through those quickly for you now. First of all, we're going to be using Cycorax Bronze to highlight all the bronze and gold parts at the same time, and then we'll move on to Carrick Stone to highlight all the belts, and finally Eschen Grey to highlight the boots. But starting out with Cycorax Bronze, again using a small layer brush, the technique is, well, the same as what we did for the silver really. You just need to get some of the paint onto your palette and thin it down so it's flowing really smoothly and easily. And you just got to make sure you got that good tip on your brush so you got lots of control over the paint. And when you're ready, all you got to do is start picking out all the sharper edges of both the gold and the bronze parts. Next, we're ready to use Carrick Stone to highlight all the details we've previously base coated using Zandri Dust. So you're looking at all the leather straps, the sash, and also the gloves. And finally, we just need to highlight the boots using Eschen Grey. There really isn't much to do here. You've just got this line running across the top of the foot just along here. But also, we've got this little rounded bit on the ankles on the side here. With those highlights applied, we just have one more thing left to do, and that is to paint in the eyes. And remember, so far we have dotted them with a small amount of Stormhost Silver. Now what we're going to do is add some Soulstone Blue to them. Now the application this time is going to be a little bit different from how we normally use this paint. We're not going to go straight out the pot with it, because I want a little bit more control over it than we normally have, because these eyes are quite small. What we need to do is just put a small amount of it on the palette there like that, and then add a little bit of water to it just to thin it down so it's a little bit easier to control. So you want it to be kind of like that. And when you're ready, all you've got to do is hold your hands as steady as possible and paint this over the silver part in the centre of the eye. And once done this, all you've got to do is base your miniature, and as always, I recommend you base it in the same way as the rest of your army. And with the base fully painted, this Arkanaut is now ready to join the rest of his company and take to the skies in search of loot and plunder. So when you're painting these miniatures, there's just a couple of things to bear in mind. And the first is that when you apply your base coats, remember to apply them as multiple thin coats to ensure all your detail stays nice and sharp. When you apply the shade all over it, keep an eye on it to make sure it settles correctly and doesn't pull too much towards the bottom of the miniature, in particular around the greaves. And finally, when you're highlighting it, just remember to be as neat as you can, because the neater you are, the better the final result's going to be. Now, whilst in this video we showed you how to paint a single Arkanaut, you can easily apply everything we've shown you to paint just about any infantry model in the entire Arkanaut range. It's just that some of them have more armour. In fact, you can even use these techniques to paint all the crews of your ships as well. So, I really hope you guys have enjoyed this video and learnt a lot from it, and have fun painting your Kharadron Overlords because, well, they're a real blast to paint. We'll see you all again very soon. If you enjoyed that video and you'd like to see more, then why not subscribe to Warhammer TV? It's crammed with content, including loads of other tutorials. And in fact, if you'd like to watch another tutorial right now, why not click one of the links below?